bad principal. Everybody wants to sit in the back, come up here and talk with us, but it's all right. Thank you guys for coming out tonight to 7th grade orientation. I know some people are kind of still trickling in. That's fine. We'll make them sit in the front with us. again, thank you for coming out. We're getting ready to start the 2017-2018 school year. And I know you guys have been in the same school, right? But there's definitely some changes once you get to 7th grade. We want you as parents to be aware of them. We want the students to be aware of them. And we want to make this as good of a school year as we possibly can. So that's why we have this. Thank you to our teachers. You're going to see them today. They all took some time out of their summer to come out and, again, see your kids. They're going to do some activity with your children while the adults kind of talk and have some adult conversations here. So hopefully it'll be a good evening. And, again, to an hour and a half, and then we'll get you guys out of here. To start off tonight, we are actually going to have our tech director, Mr. Jeff Schaefer. He's going to talk about computers. This year's 7th graders, your students will have the ability to have their own computer to take home and be able to use whenever they want. It's a great privilege and it's a great responsibility, and he's going to give you a little bit of insight on that. So we'll start off with him.
And I'm sure Mr. Hunter's going to pipe in a couple times on things about Mike Duss and everything. Okay, so this is, I believe, year 11 of our 1-1 program. A lot of other schools in the area, they're just starting. I think Edgerton, this is their first year, they got a 1-1. Fairview is their second year. So we've been ahead of the game for a long time, and the other schools are now kind of catching up to us by allowing the kids this access and also giving them the ability to be ahead of the game once they get out of high school and graduated. And all of our graduates have said that they're so far ahead technology-wise when they get to college of anybody else, and that's mainly because of this program. Okay, so like Mr. Hunter said, the students do have the ability to take a laptop home. In order for them to take it home, though, we do have a little protection program that helps save you a little bit of peace of mind, and also helps if the machine's damaged, lost, stolen. So it's just like any kind of insurance policy. So just like your car insurance, just like anything else, you have your premium, which we actually, a couple years ago we started because we were getting so many families that had multiple kids. We do give you a little bit of a break. It's $50 to participate in this for the first student, and then each additional student we knock $10 off, so it's $40 for each additional student. So a lot of parents have appreciated that because it saved a little bit of money there. The program, just like with your car insurance, you have a deductible. So if a screen is damaged, if the machine is lost, stolen, or anything, you only pay $150 of the replacement cost or the cost for the screen to be fixed, and then this policy picks up the rest of the cost. So like I said, it's 24/7, so as soon as this is paid and they walk out the door with it, the machine is covered. You do not have to participate. If you don't want your students to take the machine home, they just stay in the LMC. So they stay in the library. So when they get to school in the morning, they grab the machine, and then at the end of the day, they take it back to the LMC, so it charges itself overnight. So that's if you don't want your student to take the machine home. So that's probably the first thing, the most important thing. You don't get to take the machine home unless you do participate in the computer protection. Okay, so this is the first time you guys have really gotten to take the machines home. I know last year you guys had machines that you carried around the school, and then they just stayed with the school. This time you actually, as long as you participate in the computer protection, you get to take the machine home. Everybody's provided a laptop bag. You guys actually got new bags. The bags that I had previously, they had a little bit more space in them. People would put folders and all kinds of stuff in it. And occasionally they put so much in it, it would cause screens to get broken. So the bags I actually bought for you guys this year, they don't allow you to put anything but the computer in it. So that's for your protection. And that helps to keep the bag, or to help to keep the computer a little more protected. You're not going to have we were able to get a new lease. We traded in all our old computers. We got brand new ones, got brand new batteries. These batteries have like a 10-hour life of use. So that's constant use. So your machine is expected to be charged every day before you get to school, and it's going to easily last you through the school year. This year, I'm not allowing any student to carry a power adapter with them. So it is their responsibility to make sure the laptop is charged at home. If they come to school with the laptop not charged, it's going to go into the library for a period to be charged, and they're going to not have access to that computer for that period while it's charging the library. So no student, grades 7 through 12, are going to be carrying a power adapter this year. So keep that in mind. It's your responsibility to make sure the machine's charged, and it's easily going to last you through the day because these are really good batteries. I haven't had a lot of problems with this, maybe on occasion. If something goes wrong with the computer, don't try and fix it yourself. I have had some people try and take the computer apart, thinking they can fix it. First of all, that's going to immediately void the warranty on these machines. And then it's a lot more difficult for me to kind of figure out what the problem was. And if I send it to Apple, they're going to be like, hey, sorry, you're going to have to pay. It's no longer under warranty because somebody took it apart. So don't try and fix the machine yourself. If something goes wrong with it, just bring it to me immediately. If I can't fix it within like 2 or 3 minutes, I have temporary machines that I give you, and you're only going to be without the computer if I do have to send it in for maybe a period or so, and then you'll have a temporary one while your machine is getting fixed. So don't try and fix the computer yourself. Report problems immediately. Again, cleaning the machine, don't spray Windex on the display. That can ruin it. The liquid can drip down, and then your screen's gone, and then you're going to have to pay for replacement. So don't use any kind of liquid and stuff. And make sure you bring it to school every day. We really haven't had much problems with that in the past. It's just like if you forget your textbook. If you forget your computer, it's going to be a struggle in a lot of the classes that use them, because they use them more and more frequently for research and writing papers, and even in your math class for doing different things. So do make sure you bring it to school every day. Okay, internet access. Most everybody has internet at home. If you don't, it hasn't been a problem for the kids in the past. A lot of times they'll go to a friend's house. The library stays open at least 1 or 2 days a week. It stays open late and opens early, so if you need to get something done and you don't have internet, you can always come to school and work on that. McDonald's has free internet now, and the library has Wi-Fi now. So you can always find a place to get on internet. Okay, the machines are filtered while at school, so the kids can't get to really bad websites. When they're at school, we also block things like Facebook and Twitter, and MySpace is blocked, if anybody's still on MySpace. But at 303, I turn off the filter, and the only thing that's blocked is adult content and peer-to-peer kind of stuff. So once they leave school, they do have access to like Facebook and Twitter and stuff. And I mean, that's life. That's what, the way the world's going. But because in the past, a lot of parents had problems because their student would be up until 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning doing whatever on social networking. At 11 o'clock, all social networking is turned off, and it's just like this computer in the school. So they only have access to the same stuff that they have at school. But that kind of brings up another point, and I think Mr. Hunter may address this a little bit later on. These are school-owned machines. You as the parent have every right to do any kind of discipline you feel that you see fit with the student. If you don't want them on the machine after 10 o'clock, take the machine from them. A lot of parents don't want their students to be on the machine, period, after they go to bed. They'll take the machine and just put it on their nightstand, and the student just doesn't have access to it. So you are the parent. Don't be afraid to take the machine if you see they're doing something you're not comfortable with. Not a problem. It is a school-owned machine. We give them the privilege of using it, but you have every right to do whatever discipline you see fit. Okay. Last thing, pickup. Next Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I'm going to have pickup times. And on Sunday, I'm going to send an instant word out, probably just to remind everybody in the district about this. I think it's been on Facebook with newsletters and stuff that, and Twitter that Mr. Hunter and Mr. Slatter sent out. But Monday, I'm going to be from 9 to noon. And last year, I started kind of separating up a little bit because of all the sports and different activities. I do it at three different times of the day just to kind of help everybody out. So Monday is 9 to noon, Tuesday is noon to 3, and then Wednesday is going to be 3 to 6, and then I'm also going to hand out great open house next Thursday from 6 to 7. So next week, as long as you pay the computer protection and you've done and completed the online registration, I happened to look right before I came out, and there's probably less than 8 7th grade parents who still haven't not completed the online registration. So, as long as you have those two things taken care of, the students are able to pick up their machines next week. Also, Mrs. Welling's someplace. After everything's done tonight, so when we're completed, so if it takes till 7:30, at 7:30, Mrs. Welling and I will be over there if anybody wants to go ahead and pay for the computer protection. A lot of people have already done it online through the Rev Track system, but we'll also be over there. We can take cash check, and we have a machine to run the credit card or a debit card if you want. So after everything's said and done, if you want to go ahead and pay and take it care of so you don't have to worry about next week, that'd be great. Okay. If you have any questions, Mr. Hunter, I can address now, or if you think of anything later, you can email either Mr. Hunter or myself, and we'll address anything, any concerns that you have. Okay. Any questions right now? I will let Mr. Hunter take over.
Awesome. Thank you. Again, you don't have to participate in that. Right? We obviously recommend it if you can, but if you're not able to do that, that's fine. We keep those computers here at school then. They stay in our LMC. At the beginning of the day, like I said, the kids will pick them up. At the end of the day, they drop them back off there. So just so you're aware, your child will be having access to a computer either way. Okay. I wanted to introduce our teachers that came next, and then they will actually take off with your children. Hopefully come back and a little bit more intense, if you will. First off, the fine looking gentleman here on the far right. That's right. Mr. Schock. Mr. Schock is the PE teacher. They will have him for the phys ed this year. Thank you, Mr. Schock. Next up is Mrs. Chamberlain. Mrs. Chamberlain is a familiar face here at Hicksville. She had previously been our choir teacher. She is transitioning to a new role as the 5-8 guidance counselor. You probably didn't do a very good job of mentioning this earlier, but as a district, we're changing and going into three separate grade bands, K-4, 5-8, and 9-12. So I'm the middle school principal, meaning I'm the 5-8 principal, and she will be the 5-8 guidance counselor. So she'll stick around here and help me out as we move through tonight as well. Next up is Mr. Kohlmeyer. Mr. Kohlmeyer is our choir and band director as well. So if your student takes choir or band, we will have him. The fine looking outfit. He definitely dressed up today. Is Mr. Clausing. Mr. Clausing will be your student's history teacher this year. Up next we have Mrs. Zachridge. Mrs. Zachridge is an intervention specialist teacher for us. She will provide tutoring and intervention for students who need it. Next up is Mrs. Kelly Van Horn. Mrs. Van Horn is a new teacher to our district. We're very excited to have her. She comes to us from Defiance, where she actually taught French. But here she is going to be an intervention specialist teacher as well. We're excited to have her. She is very excited to be working with the lady right next to her. She gets to be the boss of her mother. That's like my dream job, you know? So, next up is Mrs. Steele. Mrs. Steele will also be in that room working with those students. New to the elementary, or from the elementary to the middle school, is Mrs. Turnbull. Mrs. Turnbull will be our 7th grade ELA teacher. So this is Mr. Stevenson. He is our 7th grade art teacher. They will have him in the rotation, so they'll have him for one quarter this year. So these are the teachers that you will be familiar faces to you this school year, students, and hopefully familiar faces to you as parents as well. So again, thank you to all of you for coming. And I know they have an activity planned outside. So students, at this time, if you guys would quietly rise up and head to the playground, they are going to have an activity.
Something.
They can read a magazine. They can read a newspaper. They can read a book for pleasure. But they have to read something. In fact, most of your teachers, if you walk around the building, most of your teachers are reading. You walk around the building, you will see me with a book sitting down in somebody's classroom and reading with them because I want them to know that I think it's important. So one of the programs that we do is what we call STARS. Our goal is 25 books a year. The kids actually have to track and then put into the computer how many pages that they've read every single week. So one of our programs is what we call STARS. Again, I think it's something that's important for lifelong learners and to kind of create some interest really in reading. So that's one of the things that we do here. We also do and utilize what we call PRIDE. We are what we call a high school that works and a making middle school work school. And because of that, we get a little bit of extra funding if we do a certain number of things, certain number of hoops that we have to jump through. So one of the things that we're actually able to do that we take advantage of and I think is really neat is what we call PRIDE. And PRIDE is something that happens before school or after school. And teachers will sign up different days of the week and say, hey, I'll take Monday, I'll do Tuesday, I'll do Wednesday. And your son or daughter has a chance to go work extra on a subject that they're struggling in. Some teachers will do it before testing. Some teachers will do it when they notice that your son or daughter is behind and they want to help them catch up. But if you call in and you have questions for me and you say, hey, you know, my son or daughter is struggling academically, what can I do? I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. Number one, have you talked to the teacher? And if you haven't talked to the teacher, I'm not in that classroom. You're not in that classroom. I have no idea how we can help your son or daughter. Okay. The second thing I'm going to ask is, have they attended PRIDE? Like I said, those teachers are here for an hour before school or after school. Every single day of the week, we have some sort of intervention after school or before school that they can be utilizing to help them out. And so I think that's something that's very important and something that we take advantage of. So you will hear about PRIDE. I'll actually be sending a schedule home or probably doing it electronically. We're trying to not send paperwork home. But there will be a PRIDE schedule. And again, it'll be Monday might be math. Tuesday might be history. Wednesday might be English. But different days of the week when we are utilizing different things to help your son or daughter out after school. STEP, so the Student Teacher Empowerment Program, is another one of our programs we have here. STEP is constantly changing with, again, the state of Ohio changing what we have to do. Like I said, it's kind of fun trying to hit a moving target, but that's what we do with them. What that'll be is STEP is a program that we utilize during home base. The biggest thing that it does is we're helping your son or daughter plan for their career. Start thinking about, man, what do I want to do with my life? Do I really want to be in the sciences? Do I like history? Do I like math? And what kind of jobs could I get with that? And just get them thinking along the lines of what they might be good at and what kind of classes they might need to take. And as they get older, we have different things that we're kind of helping them along. You know, what kind of colleges might I want to go to if I want to be an engineer? And so that's a program that we, again, utilize throughout the school year as a way to help your son or daughter consider what they might want to be as they get older. Some support programs that we have here for the school. Again, sometimes if your son or daughter is struggling, sometimes just to help them out, we have home base every single day. Home base is a period of time blocking about 25 minutes at the end of the school day where they have no academics that they have to do. It's an opportunity to do homework. It is an opportunity to meet with teachers. Because all teachers have home base at the same time as well. If I have trouble in math, you have the ability to go talk to your math teacher. If I'm having trouble in chemistry, I can go talk to my chemistry teacher. All those teachers are available and all the students are available. And so if they utilize that time wisely, they can get a lot of work done. They can get a lot of help if they need it from other teachers. So that's one of the big things that we have at the end of our day. I mentioned before, but PRIDE is usually before school or after school. And again, it's something that kids can take advantage of to help them out. LMC Extended Hours. Our LMC is our library media center, for those of you that didn't realize that. But we also have extended hours where Mrs. Hoffman will actually stick around, sometimes till 4, sometimes later than that. Again, it just gives that student an opportunity to have the internet if they didn't have the internet at home. It gives them a chance to check out books, a chance to go read books, a chance to work on homework and have her help. So we do have LMC extended hours as well. One of the biggest things that you can do, I think, as a parent to support your child is to contact us. We enjoy it. We want to hear from you. Contact your guidance counselors. Contact your teachers. Contact me. You can call us. You can email us. Social media. We try to make ourselves available to you guys at all times, really. So please, please, please contact us. Talk to us. Again, I think it's important to realize we're on the same team. We're all trying to help out your son or daughter. We want the best for them. And it's important to just contact us. Talk with us. We also have study halls, and I'm excited to announce that one of the things that we're doing with study halls this year is we actually are going to run, at the end of the 9 weeks, a grade report. If your son or daughter has multiple Fs on their grade card, their social media or their computer is going to get put on lockdown. Right now, if a kid really wants to, they have access to a lot of different things that maybe aren't school-related on their computer throughout the day. And if you really watch them, some of those kids work really hard at not working. It's almost a gift, okay? And as we watched that and we saw that, you know, one of the things that you really start to notice is that some of the kids who aren't doing so well academically find a way to spend a lot of time on YouTube or coolmathgames.com or a lot of other things. So this year, if your son or daughter has some apps on their grade card, at the end of the 9 weeks, their grade will get put on lockdown and they will have a lot less access to do things outside of the school activities here at school. Attendance, our goal for attendance is 100%. Now, I know that's not always possible or realistic. If your son or daughter is sick, keep them at home. But our goal is to have kids here as much as possible, as often as possible, and 100% attendance is our goal. Studies have shown just how important and critical it is to academic success, to success in your guys' workplaces. You need to be there, okay? And a lot of kids who struggle, they struggle because they miss time. Time in school, whether they really are sick, whether they miss it for other things, we need them here. While we're going to three different grade bands, one of the things that we realized, for those of you who maybe have kids in different sides of the building, was we had really different attendance policies and different things that we were asking you to do if you were calling your child in sick. And as an admin team, we sat down and said, man, we got to come up with something that works for everybody. There's no way that I can call the elementary side and I have one set of rules I have to follow, and I call the high school side and I have another set of rules to follow. It was confusing. And so one of the things we sat down and tried to make them as similar as we possibly could. If your son or daughter is sick, you can call, you can email, or you can send a letter home or with them the next day that says, hey, they were sick. In the past, at the middle school, the 7 through 12 side, you only call us and say, hey, Johnny's not going to be in today. I'm like, okay, great, well, we're going to need you to write us a note tomorrow. Great. Not anymore. One time, one way to contact us, and you have to do that. Okay. Now, that being said, we get all this done, and we think we're off to a great start, and we get bombarded by the state. The state has passed House Bill 410, and because of that, we had to rewrite the attendance policy. Actually, we were at a meeting today for about 3 hours with Judge Straw's Ball from the Fines County Courts, saying, all right, what do we have to do now? And because of all these changes with the state, there are going to be some changes, but again, our biggest goal for us is to make it uniform for and to try to make it as user-friendly as we possibly can. But the attendance policy that you guys see and you guys get day one, just know that it has to be tweaked based on what the state of Ohio says, not what Hicksville says, okay? No, and all that was that just, it was our attendance policy. And like I said, the biggest thing is you can call, email, or send a note home if your child is sick. If you're going to the doctor's office for a doctor's visit, please get a doctor's note and bring that in as well. Again, that's kind of important as we go through and document everything. We'll have Mrs. Bell Mrs. Bell is tremendous when it comes to attendance and tracking your children, and we definitely need to know where they are at. So again, doctor's notes are also very important for us. The other thing I think to keep in mind with attendance is athletics. I hope as many of your kids as possible participate, whether it's sports, whether it's clubs, whether it's different activities. One of the things, though, is we have a pretty strict policy as far as attendance and being able to participate. Your son or daughter has to be here the last six periods of the day, and they have to be here at home base, or they cannot participate, and that means practice and or games that night. Yeah, I'll say that again, the last six periods of the day and home base, so they cannot participate. Now, if you have a doctor's appointment and you bring a doctor's note in, they can still participate, okay? But if they go home sick, they cannot, okay? So if you have a doctor's appointment, hey, we've got an ear infection, we've got to get it checked out, you go, you come back, you give that to your note, to Mrs. Mrs. Bell and or your coach, and they will be able to participate. That is one thing to make sure you guys note on this side of the building. Your son or daughter, they are going to have more responsibility this year. There's not going to be a teacher that walks them from class to class every single day. There's not going to be somebody who says, okay, let's take out our books and write down all of our assignments anymore. The biggest thing that we're really going to start to teach these kids is responsibility. All right? And with that responsibility, they have to be organized. They will all get an agenda binder. And that agenda binder, they can write down their assignments. They can write down all the work that they have to do. I would say as parents, check it. See what they have. What's going on? Do they have homework that's done tonight? If not, why not? What did you do? Did you get it done? Do you have a test coming up? I would definitely be checking that information. I would find out what they had, and I would encourage them to be organized. We're going to do our part here. During home base, teachers will actually go take kids and say, hey, your locker's a mess. We're going to go organize it. And they'll pull them out, and they will try to help keep these children as organized as possible. But a lot of this also falls on them, and it becomes a thing where they have to do their share, have to take a little bit of responsibility. So agenda books, I think, are something that's pretty important as far as we're concerned. Dress and appearance. We think that there's an emphasis on the way you dress. We think it's important. We think it's something that, as the kids are here, we want them following our dress code. And we have I would call it a fairly strict dress code, okay? And I want to hit on some of the points that I see quite a bit. The biggest set of dress code issues is almost always on an athletic day, and we're going to dress up, whether it's cheerleaders or basketball players, or it's like a dress-up day of some sort. And truthfully, when they come in, they look very nice. They look like they've taken care of themselves. They're excited. They're proud of themselves. But they have to follow that dress code, okay? And what we do with the dress code, and specifically, I guess here I'm talking females, is 5 inches from the knee. So if they are wearing a skirt, that skirt has to be 5 inches from the top of their knee to where that skirt goes, okay? The very first time the dress code is broken, that is a detention. They get a warning day one. We'll sit down and have a meeting with all of our students. When you get there, 5 inches from the knee, what we use is a note card. All right? We use a 5-inch note card that we'll put up to their knee. If it's good, you're fine. If it's not, you have a detention. And in fact, we don't send them back into class until they've either changed or put on a different outfit or call mom and dad to bring them something. So if it's questionable, I would recommend leaving it at home. Torn, tattered jeans are another one that we get a lot of. You cannot be wearing torn or tattered jeans to school. And the biggest kind of comment that we always get from kids is, well, I've worn this 5 times, and now you're going to punish me? And I guess our response pretty much is that, you know, if I get pulled over by the police for speeding, I don't say, I go to speed every single day, and you're just now going to pull me over? You know, I'm not going to tell the police officer that. We don't catch everybody, okay? And we're not out there trying to just check out kids' clothing every single day. But when they get brought to our attention, we are going to deal with it. And again, with torn or tattered jeans, we would sit them in the office, they would get detention, and they will have to contact mom or dad, or sometimes they have gym clothes, or a friend has an outfit that they can put on, but they're not allowed to leave the office until that's taken care of. So just so you're aware, I would take the time with my son or daughter to go through the dress code, to read it, to make sure I understand it. Another big one I wanted to make sure I hit was actually leggings or yoga pants. A lot of kids thought that they could wear a t-shirt, wear leggings, then wear a t-shirt. You are more than welcome to do that. Your t-shirt must go within 5 inches of your knees. Okay? They're allowed to have leggings or yoga pants, and then a dress or a sweater or a t-shirt, but that shirt has to go within 5 inches of their knees in order to count and be okay with our dress code. So just so you guys are aware of that, again, I would take the time, go over that, and make sure that they are understanding that. Some of our school-wide classroom rules: dress, act, and speak appropriately. Respect the rights, ideas, dreams, and properties of others. Know and use the Hicksville Essentials. The Hicksville Essentials, I'm not going to read them to you, they're up here on the back of the screen. The Hicksville Essentials are kind of our culture, our identity, our set of rules that we follow here. We want your son or daughter to know them, right? And we think they're important, and we hit on them daily, weekly, over and over again. But really, I think you just kind of break down our essentials. It's be nice, you know, be respectful, take care of yourself, take care of others. That's essentially what it comes down to. But I would definitely recommend taking a look at them. They are in your agenda books. They are on our school website. They are plastered all over the walls here at our school. So that's something that, again, we think is pretty important. Real quick, at our school, we think it's important to respect each other. And I wanted to talk here just a second or two. One of the buzzwords, I guess, in education is bullying. I get all kinds of phone calls about bullying. And to talk about that, I want to make sure that we understand. When you guys get your stories from your son or daughter, you're getting their side of the story. And oftentimes, we haven't heard about it yet. We haven't had any idea what's going on, and a parent will call and they're irate that their child's being bullied. Now, when they call, and a lot of times people are upset. I understand you guys as kids are the most valuable things that you have, the most important things that you have. And so people get emotional when they're talking about it. Well, we're going to go do the best that we can. You've got to give us some time. You know, with cell phones and everything else, you guys oftentimes find out about something happening long before we do. Okay? And again, give us some time to investigate, give us a chance to go find out what's going on. But I'll tell you that 9 times out of 10, that after we go ahead and we talk to the different people involved, and we pull them down out of the office, and we're having a conversation with them, almost every time, I wouldn't call it bullying, okay? I'd call it two kids who had a dispute. I would call it two kids who oftentimes, I won't say your kid, but the party who's complaining, both sides play a role, all right? Not very often we have just one victim. We usually have a couple of people who are fighting back and forth and having an argument. You know, when we're talking bullying, we're talking something that happens over and over and over again. It's repeated. It's something where we don't have two parties that are fighting with each other. It's one person who's being victimized, and they've asked them to stop, and it's being repeated. It's something that we do take very seriously. In fact, we are having a bullying assembly. September 13th, we're actually doing that with Antwerp. Okay, so again, this is something that we take seriously. And then we also, at Antwerp that night at 6 o'clock, are having an adult assembly, really, at Antwerp. And again, it's an adult assembly to discuss bullying and what it is and what it is not and how it's affecting our kids. So I don't want you to think it's not something that we take seriously, but I also want you to understand that you're hearing one side of the story more times than not. And a lot of times people call in with complaints of bullying, and it's really not bullying. So give us a chance to check it out. We will, and we'll get back to you. We want you to make sure that they're respecting our teachers, our staff, respect our furnishings and our building. We have the nicest building in Northwest Ohio. I don't care what anybody says, bar none, our building is the nicest building. It's 10 years old, and it's taken care of. Our kids take care of it, our staff takes care of it, and that's why this is nice. So I want to make sure that you understand that our children are going to take care of this building, and they're going to be expected to take care of this building. we expect that they are behaving in class with their teachers. We expect that they're behaving at lunchtime. The older they get here in seventh grade, they don't necessarily have as much free time. They don't have recess anymore. They don't have some of these things. So when you get down here to the cafeteria during lunchtime, they're excited. And that's more than okay to be excited. You have a chance to sit with your friends. You get to talk about your day. You get to a little bit of freedom again. But when you're down here, we expect that you're respectful. And that means to each other. That means picking up after yourself. Nothing will frustrate us. The cafeteria staff, the custodial staff, you have a big mess around your table. That's not okay with us. Your moms don't work here. And if they do work here, they're not picking up after you. That's not okay. When you're in line and you're getting your lunch food, that's great. You're going to behave. You're going to treat people with respect. You're going to be nice to one another. That's what we expect. All right? And again, we expect that in our school at all times. Crucial conversations, some things that I think it's important at this age that mom and dads kind of start to talk with their children about. One of them for boys, we'll talk about boys and then girls. For boys, one of the big issues is computer searches. Mr. Schaefer was up here talking about it. Computer searches and what kids type into computers. There is nobody better than Mr. Schaefer who's going to find out what was put on that computer. There's nobody better. And we get back to school, and a lot of times, even if they search at home with our filter, it'll pop up with what they searched for that night. And Mr. Schaefer will go, "Hey, Mr. Hunter, just so you know, this was in our search terms." And we got to call them down and have a conversation. Kids, these are the school computers. Don't type in things that you shouldn't be. Maturity for boys, you're starting to hit that age where it's time to start to grow up a little bit, all right? That's always a big one, especially down here at lunch. Again, it's your free time, but we want you to make sure that you're using it and acting responsibly. Respect for young ladies. Guys, we expect that you're treating the young ladies in this school with respect. I don't expect to ever hear names being called. I don't expect you guys to be mean, to make comments, to be hurtful. It's time that we start to grow up a little bit. And that's something that, again, I think at this age we want to see from our young men. Another one is cell phones. Okay, we do not allow cell phones here at the school. Not allowed. Do kids have cell phones in this school? Yeah, every one of them. Alright? I'm well aware of it. However, when it gets caught, I'm taking it. When you get caught with it, it's mine. We do have a no cell phone policy. And the only way that I'm not going to go down and say, "Hey, I see a cell phone in your pocket, it's mine." I'm not doing that. But if you have it out in the hallway and you're texting, it's mine. If it goes off in a class and you get a text message, it's mine. When we take a cell phone, you get a detention. When we take a cell phone, mom and dad, you have to come get the cell phone from us. The second time, they get a Friday school. The third time, they're going to be suspended. Again, I'm going to say this, because immediately every time that we say this, I'll have a parent who comes in and says, "Well, how am I supposed to contact my child? We have phones here at the school. They do work most of the time." You can email your child. You can they will have their own email address. You can email them. You can call us and say, "Hey, can you get this message to them?" We'll get it to them. If you're worried about emergencies, I know that your kids have cell phones. Tell them to shut them off. If something's going on here, they can turn them on and they'll have access to them. All right, so again, quick note about cell phone. What happens if they get taken? Girls, respect towards each other. That's a big one. I would say that 70% of all girls in my office last year were just because they were being catty and mean to each other. It's almost unbelievable to me how mean that a group of girls can be, and then the next day, they turn around and they're best friends again. I didn't understand it. I couldn't put it all together. But day in and day out, that's what happened. Girls, be nice to each other. Alright? They're your friends. Please keep it that way. Dress code. I know I kind of touched on dress code. 90% of the dress code issues that we have come from young ladies. And again, most of the time it's from when they're dressing up and they're getting ready for an athletic event or a science fair or doing something. Just make sure that what you're wearing is 5 inches from your knee. Make sure that the strap is, I think it's 4 inches across. Take a look at that dress code, know the dress code, and make sure you're following it, please. Social media is a hot topic as well. Be nice to each other on social media. Okay? What you guys do or what you say, it sticks with you for a very, very, very long time. And you put that out there, and so many times, guys, you'll say things to each other on social media that you would never, ever in a million years say to somebody else's face. You shouldn't do it. You shouldn't do it. The number of complaints that I get when people call in and they'll say, hey, you know, they're talking bad about my daughter. What I want you to understand is this, two parents. I'm very limited on what I'm able to do with it. If it's not a school computer that was being used, if it's not being done on school time, if it's not being done and causing issues at school, if they're not making threats about school, I can't go punish that other child. Okay? I can't punish them here at school necessarily for what they're doing at home. Some of that is just parenting. And if it's bad, what I would recommend is I would get my kid off social media. If it's really bad, I would be monitoring what they're doing on social media. You know, I don't want to forget, you guys are the parents, all right? You're in charge of your kids. And I wouldn't hesitate to take social media from my kid, and I wouldn't hesitate to say we don't need that kind of stuff in our house. So just a quick FYI. One of the things I think, kids, that is huge to your success here is to get involved. We want you guys to be as involved at this school as you possibly can. We have a wonderful sports program. We have all kinds of clubs and activities. It's huge. And again, in order for our school to function, in order for our school to be as good as it possibly can be, we need all of you. And what we see is the kids who are involved don't get in trouble. The kids who are involved have a reason to keep their grades up. The kids who are involved tend to do very well here. And so I'm encouraging each and every one of you, and parents, I hope you guys encourage your children, get involved. And we've got football, cross country, volleyball in the fall. I hope that some of you guys are taking advantage of that stuff already. We have basketball and wrestling. We have track and field. We have cheerleading. We have quiz bowl. We have school plays and musicals. We have class officers, middle school book club, middle school art club. We have archery. We have all kinds of activities, guys, that you can get involved in. No matter what you're interested in, you can find something to get involved in. And I would encourage each and every one of you guys to do that. Eligibility is a little bit different now. As you get older, things start to change. Eligibility for athletics will start the fifth week of every 9 weeks. At the end of that fifth week, guys, we'll run a report. If you have two or more Fs, you are academically ineligible to participate. That'll last for 1 week, and we'll check your grade again. If your grades are bad, you are academically ineligible to participate. At the end of that 9 weeks, if you still have the two Fs, you cannot participate for the next 9 weeks. So it's important to keep your grades up, but also to keep your grades up year-round. I want to make sure you understand. Let's say Bobby plays basketball. Doesn't play football, plays basketball. Doesn't really care what his grades are like that first 9 weeks. Flunks it. It's two Fs. He can't play basketball. Maybe he says, I play football. I keep my grades up. I do great stuff all fall, but I don't do anything else here at the school. And he slacks off for the rest of the school year. That end of your seventh grade year will allow you to be eligible for the beginning of your eighth grade year, okay? So you have to keep your grades up in the spring if you want to be eligible in the fall. So grades are now obviously being tied to athletics, and that's a big part of keeping yourself eligible. And the other thing is to make sure that you are here at school so you are eligible to participate in practice today. I know Mr. Shaker has mostly talked about computers. I wanted to touch on a few things myself just to make sure that you guys are aware. I can't tell you how lucky, guys, that we are to have these computers. To have access to these computers, to be able to take them home, to be able to use them. We have a huge advantage over every other school district. When your students go to college, they have a huge advantage over so many other kids. I can't explain it to you. So we're incredibly lucky for this opportunity. But with that, a lot of times there are also things that we need to be very careful with. We talked about searches. We talked about the way that they're being used. We take it very seriously. And I guess to kind of explain how seriously we take it, guys, We have a computer right now that's currently at the police department. Okay? When that stuff gets on there, it's saved. Those keystrokes, every time you type something, it's saved. I don't know how to pull it up, but somebody way smarter than me does. And like I said, we have a computer right now that is at the police department being used in part of it as an investigation. Okay? So kids, be responsible with them. Think before you do things with them. Alright, that stuff will come back to haunt you if you're not taking care of it properly. And another big thing that I want to hit on is you guys are the parents. The number of phone calls that I got, hey, my kid will not get off the computer. Now they want to be on it at 2 in the morning trying to watch Netflix. You know, Mr. Schaefer has all kinds of great blocks. Kids come up with stuff so fast to get around blocks, it's not funny. And my kid's up at 2 in the morning watching Netflix. Shut the computer off, man. Take it away from them. You guys are the parents. Set rules, set parameters. If you don't want your kid in their bedroom on their computer, that's perfectly okay. If you don't want your kid using it past 10 o'clock, that's okay. I think it's important that you guys have a set of rules with their school computers. We can put them on lockdown if you guys are interested. Now, I want you to understand, like, a number of parents have come in and say, hey, my kid's not using social media correctly. I don't want them to be allowed to go on Facebook. I don't want them to be on Twitter. I don't want them to, hey, we can do that. We can put a lockdown on. But we're doing it once. Okay? It's not a, hey, my kid is sick this week, so we don't want social media again. No. But we put a lockdown on it, we'll do it. But we're going to do it one time. Schedules are put in place by alphabetical order. If your last name starts starts with A through F. Don't move yet. Don't move yet. A through F, Mrs. Chamberlain will have them. You'll get in line and she will pass those out to you. If your last name starts with Shh, W, Mr. Flausen will have them. If your last name is M through C, Mr. Schock will have them. Is there any others? And G through L, Mrs. Reese will have them. I will be around. There are plenty of them. Oh, I should have mentioned this to start with. Wow. We have all kinds of snacks, and I'm not taking them home with me. A couple different kinds of pretzels, different kinds of chips. Please grab some snacks. You're right out the door, guys. I'm sorry that I forgot to mention that before we started. Take that home. If you have any questions, we will be around. Also, just a reminder, if you want to pay your computers, tonight, this line is over here in order to help with that. Also, if you want to put money in your lunch accounts, Mrs. Pyramid is here to help with that as well. Other than that, thank you. Have a great year.